Hello everyone, this is Paolo again, and this is another draft video. And I'm using a different headset now, so hopefully there will be no problems regarding the sound. This pack's pretty good. There are three cards that are way above the rest, which are the Nibblers of the Mist, the Vault of the Archangels, and the Immerwolf. On power level alone, I think the Vault of the Archangels is the better card, but it's also the most limiting, because it locks me into colors, which is not a bad color combination, but not the best color combination I can be. It's the third of the white decks. Like, green white is better and blue white is better. Black white is the third white deck. So, I think Nibblers of the Mist is powerful enough that I would rather just take it and be more open to, like, a more consistent. Like, this is probably gonna be better in the majority of the decks. This is only gonna be better in straight black white. And the chances I go black white are not very high. So, I'll just take the Nibblers here. This deck's pretty bad compared to my previous pack. If I had taken the Vault of the Archangels, I think I would have taken Undying Evil here. But since I didn't, there's no reason to take it. I think the best card in this pack is probably the Pyroheart Wolf. But red black, sorry, red white is not a good color combination. It's not. I don't think it's unplayable. Like Ben, for example, would say he'll never play red white in his entire life. He says he thinks it's horrible. I don't think it's horrible. It's certainly not good. But is the wolf better enough than the griffin that is worth it? I think so. It's also a combo of the Nibblers. Yeah, I'll just take the wolf here, and if I don't play it, then I don't play it. Oh, interesting. Very good pack here for me. For anyone, basically. This card's good. Even Bloodfield is not. Like, when we first saw the set, I thought Bloodfield was insane. But then after playing with it a little bit, it's just not that good. So options here are Forge Devil, Nibblers of the Mist. Oh, this is the Mist. This is the Urn, sorry. And the Spirit. I would say the Spirit is a little bit better. But not that much better than the 2-1 Flyer. They're both better than the Forge Devil, I think. So in a super aggressive deck, I might actually win the 2-1. The Spirit is a lot better in blue white though, because you have like this counter spell, bounce spells, other flash guys. Which one? Which one? I think the Spirit is better than the 2-1. This might be wrong, but I think it is. Whoa. A Boneflinger? That's pretty late for a Boneflinger. Even though the spec's probably insane, because. Well, it can't really be. Well, there could be a rare upheaval and a flip card, I guess. Because all the three uncommons. Well, wait, the flip card's here. So, a rare foil and an uncommon. Yeah. That's possible. There are even some commons that someone might take over if they're in different colors. Like I'm gonna do right now. Yeah, I'm just gonna take the 2-1 Flyer here. This is obviously a better card, but I think at this point I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be white and I don't know anything about any other colors. And the second of them. It's pretty good. Pretty good aggressive deck so far. I have four guys, they all fly. Not the best possible pack for me. I'm definitely gonna be white, so there's no point in taking this vampire. Sorry. I could take Young Wolf, but that's just not good. I could take the equipment, also not good. I don't have any humans yet. Probably just gonna take one of the vampires. I think the Vengeful Vampire is better, but in a black-white deck, the Tormentor, the Torturer, or whatever it's called, could possibly be better. So if I pick like Elder Guitars and stuff like that, I'll want this guy. Whereas this is always going to be mediocre in this kind of deck. Ooh, another one of those? My first pick? The card that I first picked over Vault of the Archangels, I just got 7th. Oh, well, I'll take it. This card is very, very good. Unlike those cards, which are just horrible. What does this even do? It pumps. Is this even playable? I do have a lot of flyers and ways to push them through. Is this better than Chalice of Life? It probably is. I'm probably not gonna play any. I'll just stick the land here. Midnight Guard is not the best card in the world, but it's better than Break of Day, I think. I don't really like Break of Day. Griffin. I don't really like the Griffin, but oh well, it's definitely playable. I've played a lot of worse cards. Here, Bone to Ash. Yeah, Bone to Ash. Oh, I could take an. I'm not gonna play two of the land, so I could take Rare Revelation or Saving Grasp. I don't have a second color yet, and Saving Grasp is actually potentially main deckable. Especially if I get Fiend Hunter, that's such a ridiculous combo. And I do have two Nibblers of them, so worst comes and a Hallowhand Spirit. So worst comes to worst, I can bounce them back and do some sort of tricks. Moorland Haunt, interesting. So Moorland Haunt and Bonds of Faith are the best cards here, I think. Even though in such an aggressive deck, Grass might be good, I think Bones is just better. Because it's not like my guys have infinite power, so I might just be rushed. And if you're being rushed, this is not good. That's actually tough. The thing is, I don't actually know that I'm white red yet. Blue white yet. I don't have any reason to be blue. I don't have any blue cards. My two blue cards are bad. So I'm just gonna take Bonds of Faith here. And maybe I reread it, but there's a chance that the other card tables. This is. Like, not many people want Moorland Haunt. But that's probably not gonna happen. Here is between Rage Thrower and Archer Spirit. Let's do a Custer. I'm just gonna take this Torturer out of here. I'm not gonna play it. Unless something very weird happens. I could take the Rage Thrower. But I think maybe just the Archer Spirit. Yeah, I'll just take the Archer Spirit. I have enough white cards. Good white cards, like white cheap flyers. The travel prep is gonna be insane if I get it. So those are my green cards. I'm happy. I don't really need anything else. Now I'm taking a Shepherd. There could be a blue white, sorry, a green white deck, which Butcher's Cleaver is better than Shepherd, but this is certainly not it. So at this point, I'm kinda committed to green white, I guess, which is. Not bad, it's the best color combination. I mean, I'm certainly not committed, I don't have two green cards, but. So if I open a Mega Bomb in pack 3, I can just take it and move to those colors, and it's gonna be fine. Slavless Katara or Woodland's Lute? They're both bad, but. They're both different. If my opponent has a lot of flyers, then we're gonna play a flyer turn 3, I'm gonna attack, and it's gonna trade. So then the Woodland's Lute is gonna be good. The Slavless Katara, not too much. My guys have small toughness, so I was not gonna pump them very much. So I'm just gonna take this Lift here. And Spider Grasp. I like Spider Grasp. It's a fine trick overall. It's better than my second option, which would be One Eye Scarecrow at this point. Because it's main deckable, I'm not gonna main deck One Eye Scarecrow. This pack, not so good for me. I suppose it could take Harvest Pyre, which is. It's either Harvest Pyre or Naturalize. I'm not very likely to play Harvest Pyre. I cannot imagine a lot of situations where this would come into play. It would probably include a bunch of Traveler Amulet, but. So, Naturalize or Mask, actually. Mask is playable. I'm just gonna take. What am I gonna take? I'm gonna take Naturalize. I think I'm more likely to side it in and have it be Porter, of course, a second Naturalize. Also, second Mask. I knew those cards were here though. Didn't I? Or was this pack just very similar to one that I already passed? Anyway, I'm taking Mask here. Since I already have a Naturalize. Not good. Bramble Crush? I already have a Naturalize. I don't really want a Bramble Crush. Let me just hide those. At this point, I kind of want playables. I don't have a whole lot of them. Like, Mask is not really a good playable. Yeah, I guess I'll take. No, I'll take Stitcher's Apprentice here. Because I might open a good blue card and I doubt just. Or table their Moorland Haunt. Which I am taking. And a Kindercat. Deck, of course. Maybe I sat in against a very slow deck. Especially the prevention of not batting my deck. There's someone with a very good. And there's rings of that deck somewhere. Luckily, I have two naturalizes. So at this point, I just have to show all the cards again. Because I hate the blue cards, because I'm an idiot.
Woo!